no bo ambe pase no a salu mi lente u timba ngo ngo umuntu nje sisimandla kazi 1 sisimandla kazi 2 obudyan ni nonke nje bolqhudeni sicela sibakhwabele izandla sondelani please senze uba naba be photographs Juan Laura left a legacy behind, not only in terms of genes, nalo sapho oluyelwaza ngale ndlela inhle kangaka kwaba lapha around umthatha ngomgqibelo I think kuzilwa nomisa masibakhwabeleni zana. Thank you, thank you. Hayi noko iikhamera zimthathile kodwa ndimbonile lowe-alcatel besabuyisela ibhethi nithe nibuyele ezindaweni zenu kwabe sekonakele. So I'll be recognizing people along the way without any waste of time. Masicele umama okwayingu-acting deputy vice chancellor academic affairs and research professor Bandla Cishe okwayi-product yale ndawo. Let's put our hands together.
They know themselves, allow me to say so. Special guests that include the judiciary. He has elaborated on that. Walter Sisulu University staff and students. I'm proud that the choir that made the program director to see Jerusalem is the WSU choir. And Laurent Patra's former colleagues, they have been mentioned. I note there was a time when the university started to recruit colleagues who were coming from other countries and those who grew up in other countries. They had a problem in pronouncing her surname, and there was this colleague who would say, Professor Imfenyan. We used to call him like that, and we tried to correct her, to show her what that meant. Our mother, Professor Luswazi, nama peleka azila, ali peleka azili, li pele, elia bobabini. These are the people, including Aunt Laura, who did not sleep, were working at night when the then Minister of Education, the late Professor Kedar Asman, wanted to shut down this university. They fought very hard, and here we are today. The Mthatha community, including the healthcare centers, I have noted them. Students, WSU staff, WSU students, and the St. John's College. I just want to tell you one thing, learners of St. John's, your principal was my student. I'm proud of him. If I could do that and say my students here should stand up, hey, Nancy. Both executive mayors, ORKSD, were my students. His speaker, says a provincial, and many others. I don't have time to do that. Otherwise, many of them were my students. The family you have just seen, Aunt Laura Patra family, the organizing committee. I was told earlier on, but I have not mentioned, that my king is expected. I hope my king will soon join us, the king of Abatim. Good evening. Mine is a small task to welcome you all to Iziko likaTata uKhamela. Unokuyinhla, uTata Walter Sisulu University. We are one, in fact, I think we are the only fortunate university in South Africa that is associated with four political legends from this province. We are situated at our street here, King Sabata Dalingebo local municipality. Where is that one? It is at O.R. Tambo district municipality. And the road itself is Nelson Mandela Drive. And we are a Walter Sisulu University. Are you for any? Patra was recruited at this university. It was then University of Transkei. In the Faculty of Health Sciences at the time, Professor Fenyana, Professor Luswazi, it is now called Faculty of Medicine and Health Sciences. When she joined us, she spearheaded the formation of community partnerships and also the establishment of health centers. The professors, the two professors I have mentioned here, they know some of them, being Omhlakulo, Nebaziya. I'm not going to mention all of them. She spearheaded these partnerships not only with communities, but through our traditional leaders, that is SWSU, even today, we respect the traditional leaders. There was also, it was a kind of a tripartite relationship. Walter Sisulu University, our communities, and the Department of Health. In those partnerships, working with others, they helped our students, that is military students at the time, to get exposed to learn about sickness and environment. Why were those combined? Because they felt that sickness should not be learned in isolation. Umntana njengam ophuma phakusakhela xa egula akanodityaniswa nomntana wasemishini ekokolweni kuba sizufana. So that is what they were doing, because they wanted to make sure that what is the relationship or the link between sickness and one's environment. And Laura worked a lot, or in fact, let me say, she was recruited for what was formed or established at the time, known as the University and Community Healthcare Partnership Program, which was shortened as UCHCP, and it was then in 1990 when she was co-opted into that program. She served in 2 years. Professor Swazi will remember that she was already with us. There was a lot of time she was in Germany.
Sawuphazamisa nje kancinci ukwamkela ingotya ekumkani yabathembu. Sizawucela xa sele engeni lootata baphakame. Sizomkhahlela kakuhle sele ngenile umntana egazi. Itholele silo. Esi silo ngokunokwakhe. Sizawucela ootata baphakame. Azwe lubanzi. Azwe lubanzi. Azwe lubanzi. Sibulela ngalo mbeko asenzele yona umntana egazi kuba kaloku ezi projects zizawenzeka kwezaa ndawo zakhe xa ke sinikwe i-blessing litholele silo usibali kuba kaloku uzeke emaxesha ibe nabanye abayazi loo nto nje ukuba umacishe ebebreka nge-WSU kuphela mna sendiwele nangapha ukumkani ngusibali.
Kumkani undibonile ukukhophe kancinci phaa emnyango ngoku ndithetha ngathi sise-King Sabata Dalindyebo municipality wakhoba waphinda wabuya umva. Yintombi yakusakhela le ime apha singaske siphinde sithethe xa sinethuba. Yikumkani yam leya niyikleyimayo yeyam kanye kanye ncakasana ndiphaa kumhlaba kasakhela. I have already mentioned that Aunt Laura served as an interface between the university and the community. In the year 2000, the University of Transkei, because we're not yet Walter Sisulu, honored her with a doctor in primary health care sector, acknowledging the role Aunt Laura has played in primary health care. I knew her and interacted with her in person. You can imagine, ba nobana nimnganani, kanithina kudala as a lab assistant. Inguye ke no Professor Chafta. Babethi xa bendibiza bathi pikinini kamanandimncini. She was humble. Jemani Mbona. Martha Lee, she was not only the mother to you, the mother to us as well. Her smile, as you can see, all the time. We are, as Walter Sisulu University, blessed to have been associated with Aunt Laura Mphahlwa. I said in the beginning, Dr. Aunt Laura Mphahlwa. Dingeka suki kwesi stulo, dize apha, bendimabanditsho ukuqaleni, ndizomela
Umam Thembu, Usis Linda Kobodo, Ongu Sister Ga Chancellor. They connected to the Pandaba Kurunji Glen down the road, didn't tell it. Ulapa and I, let's put our hands together. O Deputy Mayor wase OR Tambo, Umangasa na umdwa gloma kulum kiwa utunjana. Ulapa na ye umam soka nyile. Let's put our hands together for him. Kanti, we have just been joined by UMEC Wagwa Health Ebesak by Mayor, Executive Mayor se OR Tambo. Yena ungumzukulwana kaba umkhulu Rhafana. Uyintombi kabawo uCromwell Ndawenzima Diko. Yena engunomakhosazana Math osuke Hlankomo ngakugumbini ngasechwebeni. Ilala suka kuyo ke umakhulu wami ile yasehlangoma nalapho utata omkhulu wambona khona umakhulu teacher khona kanti dane skolo maneze ngathi uzosinda kanti uyamfisha kodwa ke siyabulela uba bayenza lonto bana kusilapha. Xa sizawusuka apha sizawufumana before silungise umcimbi lo kuba kaloku premier uxolisile kakhulu wathi bekufanele ba ulapha kodwa uthumele izijoli with a brief message. Oh uthe kanti upremier ulapha ngenku into okunako acting premier othunywe ngupremier ngenku niyayazi uba lela xesha likaxakeka yiloo nto kuxakekekile ukuba ngaba umntu akathathwanga uba makalungiselele laa 29 kaMeyi omnye ubhizi ulungiselele amazwi asixhenxe kodwa kuxakekile nje. Anyway, Siza utela before siye glo message, sildale ubangaba si ready ibayaskopu. Ubangaba ke wawuzalwe before 1980, uzawuyazi ibayaskopu. Uba awuyazi ulahlekile. Ungeka ukuyochekisha ku Google Map, ku Google. Video. Before kube kwezinto ze TV nento nisasibukela ibioscope uwine iVasco xa uthe waphendula imibuzo ethile. Kwa advertise Life Boy ne Sunlight ne Surf ne Omo ndisazikhumbula. So sizawuthi nqwada lala, I hope kule ndawo izawudlalwa kuyo it is ready, but also it will be visible and the lights may be dimmed a little bit ukuba ngaba ikho bright kakhulu, kuba sifuna ukwazi ngalo mntu sithetha ngaye. Ndisaza umane ndazisa kuba ndiseza kumagqale behamba nomama uLaura Mphahlwa. Bona xa uvela ube ne-nickname kuthiwe Aunt Laura, noba sowuna 92 kuthiwe Aunt Laura. Kangaba nosihlalo webhodi sive sabona uba masifumane umntu naye kuthiwa nguBradi, noba uba na-60 kuthiwa Bradi, abe na-70 sithi Bradi, kube kwathiwa advocate judge sithi Bradi. So ke siye sabona uba masibenze low two matching. Ingaba are we succeeding with the video? So that, thank you very much.
Life for Aunt Laura really began when she moved to Mthatha from Soweto to pursue a career in the nursing profession. It was in Mthatha that she met the man who was to become her life partner. In 1955, her interest in ballroom dancing resulted in her meeting Max Mphahlwa, and love blossomed for the two dance partners. They met on the dance floor as professional ballroom dancers and got married in Pietermaritzburg in 1957. One of the special characteristics of Aunt Laura is that she has maintained a very close link with her Msimanga Engcobo family, which is spread over various parts of the country in Gauteng, Pietermaritzburg, Durban, and Venda. A year later, their first bundle of joy, son Luyanda, entered their lives. Max was a teacher at St. John's College, and Aunt Laura was by his side during his tenure there. She, however, continued to pursue her nursing career and did this at Sir Henry Elliot Hospital in Mthatha. In 1960, Mandisi was born, and 2 years later, cancer came into their lives. In the same year, 1962, Max left the teaching profession and joined Shell Petroleum as a sales representative. Another two years passed, and in 1964, Mandlagazi was born. Aunt Laura raised her children and stood by her husband, but never failed in pursuit.
Whilst they're still working on the video part, because ngoku iyeyayi radio, Bandwai Radio, Transkei, yayi Capital Radio, ngoku besayilungisa uba ibe nayo i-television. Sijoinwe ngunjengele umgebe ubantu olomisa. The general himself. Let's put our hands together. Ndiyambona umgebe usaxatshisile, use ungovernable kule nto yokunikwa instruction yokuza ngaphambili. Amen. Xa isiza ngaphambili umgebe manditsho ndithi somewhere in 2007 I think sacelwa United Nations uba siyojonga ii-elections e-East Timor ngase-Indonesia ndathi kuba sizawuba kule moto imini yonke ndicela undixacacisele uba umbuso lubhukuqwa kanjani. And I want to say he obliged. One the negative blow by blow account. So let's put our hands together for who. Bonke ababantu ngabantu abamaziyo umama Lorraine Phahlwa nabasebenze naye. Ngelixesha technical team yethu isabambekile, we will move on to our next speaker. Next speaker wethu ngu acting premier wePhondo umntaka Ndayenzima uMaqholo uManci umzukulwana kaKhafana. Let's put our hands together for him. Kuba kaloku we will be working with all role players kule foundation. Kana esiza enjalo kukho i-message ebhalwa nguMarcus Cicero isithi the life of the dead is placed on the memory of the living. The love you gave in life keeps people alive beyond their time. Anyone who was given love will always live in another's heart. Sizama ukwenza loo nto ngalo msebenzi kamama uLaura. Bendizomlanda unxiba imax umama uLaura.
Thank you so much, Prof. You caught me unready. I was still trying to find my feet. My apologies for joining late. Our King, Kumkani Zulubanzi. Njengele. All the dignitaries, because I was not here when the introductions were done, if they were done. I don't want to offend leadership, but I can see the Deputy Speaker from the Provincial Legislature, the Honorable Koboshian. I can see our lecturer, the guest speaker of the day, Yusuf Notumato. All honored guests. That I hear the family, the Phahlwa family. Good evening. Molweni. I want to first apologize for the Premier who couldn't make it today, but he requested me to act, but in case I don't make it, I think there was somebody who was holding the fort. Sorry, Nyat, number one citizen, and I see you, Deputy Minister. My apologies at the cabinet today, so I was driving. I did consult and contact Uput Luyanda, explaining my predicament. It's not out of disrespect. Please allow me to profusely again apologize for our number one citizen of the Eastern Cape, Premier Mabuyane, as he was supposed to join us today. Because of other government commitments, he could not be part of this important gathering. He has tasked me to represent him and the Eastern Cape government. We welcome and appreciate to be invited here, and we want, on behalf of the people of the Eastern Cape, to also welcome all honored guests that are here, coming from our province and coming from cloth as we honor our own mother and our own daughter of the soil. It is with immense pride and a profound sense of reverence that we extend a message of support for the inaugural lecture dedicated to the memory of an extraordinary daughter of our soil, Laura Britomart Guguletu Mphahlwa, affectionately known as Aunt Laura. As we celebrate 30 years of South Africa's democracy, we are reminded of the indelible mark left by those who dedicated their lives to the service of humanity, rural development, social justice, and the pursuit of equality. And Laura's life and legacy embodies these principles in their purest form. Born on the eve of a challenging period in our nation's history, Aunt Laura emerged as a beacon of hope and resilience. Her contributions spanned across the healthcare sector, community development, and the relentless fight for social justice. As a nurse, a philanthropist, a businesswoman, and tireless advocate for the marginalized, Aunt Laura's life and work was testament to the power of compassion, leadership, and unwavering commitment to uplift others. In an era when the odds were stacked against many, Aunt Laura stood firm, pioneering initiatives that have left an enduring legacy. The Sibabalo Training Center for Disabled People, Elukolweni School Siyakhana Program, and the founding of the schools such as Umthatha International School and Ezra Sikwela Junior Secondary School are but a few examples of her visionary leadership and her dedication to education and empowerment. Her role as a founding member of the National African Federated Chamber of Commerce and Industry, now known as NAFCOC, alongside her husband, her contributions to the Vukani Women's Organization, and her leadership within the Elukolweni Street Children Organization underscore her multifaceted approach to building a solid and inclusive democracy. And Laura's posthumous honor, the honor of Luthuli in silver awarded by President Cyril Ramaphosa, is a testament to her significant impact in our province and the nation. As we reflect on 30 years of democracy, let us draw inspiration from Aunt Laura's life. Let her unwavering spirit of servant leadership motivate us to continue working towards an Eastern Cape where every citizen, regardless of their background, has the opportunity to thrive. Her legacy is our guiding light as we strive for a society rooted in equality, social justice, and compassion. In keeping her legacy on, we'll surely soon identify a government facility to be named after her. Actually, there are talks already on us considering naming the Nelson Mandela Academic Hospital Oncology after our own mother, but the seventh administration shall engage on all the processes, including consultations, so that we do that. Wow. Thank you. Today, as we pay homage to Aunt Laura, let us recommit ourselves to the ideals she lived by. Let us remember that each of us has the potential to make a meaningful impact, to continue to work and do what she was doing the best, and to ensure that her legacy endures for generations to come. Thank you, Aunt Laura, for showing us the way. May your soul continue to rest in eternal peace, and may your legacy inspire us to do more, to do better, and to do faster in pursuit of a life that is better for all of us. As I prepare to take my seat, I want to reassure the Mphahlwa family that we value and appreciate the role that our mother and Laura played in our healthcare sector and in our country. As such, consultations, as I said, of naming the state-of-the-art 412 million rand oncology of Nelson Mandela will start soon. This is our commitment of ensuring that we honor her and we make sure that her legacy continues to stay on. She is, after all, the Eastern Cape legend, a legend of the healthcare sector. We're confident that no one will object to the government's plan of honoring Aunt Laura by naming the oncology unit after her. Let us keep her memory alive and go out in our numbers to vote and vote right in Njengene on May 29th. Long live the undying spirit of Mum Aunt Laura. Long live. Thank you so much.
Njengele ndiyibonile imiyalezo ithunyelwa ukuba kuthiwa laa mini yeza asazi ukuba isizalela ntoni. Njengele apha sinamagqala ebehamba nomama uLaura endingathi uba ndiwalibale kube nzima. Ama-senior citizens, tata uSekelane nowakwakhe ndicela baphakame sithi nje amagqala, Rock of Ages. Xa sithetha nge-seasoned veterans sithetha ngamagqala nje. Sinaye apha umama uMcaba uSis Maureen Ngonyana nabanye abakhona, ndicela bave baphakame nje zegruphu sibabone kuloo ndawo bakuyo. Wow. Magala. Sinaye apha uBoot Monde noSis Lungi Gobodo, ababo siblings baka Chancellor. Oqhudeni baninzi. Isibulisele. Ne-retired nurses zilapha. Ii-board members zaseLuxolweni Street Children Program zilapha, masibaqhwabeleni zabo. I want to just mention as we go kuvuthondaba ngoku, ngelaa xesha lethu njengele kwakukho i-drum, kukho ibona, kukho i-pace, kukho i-heat, kube sekubakho uNobuhle. Sijonge pha usike loo page nekhalenda uyincamathisele eludongeni as an aspirational object. Sisinomxolisi Mjike waye kuloo category eya-identifywa ngu-Aunt Laura. Wade wawumela iTranskei kuMiss Universe, khawuphakame nkosazana. Banda bam, nyambona akakabuni. I-hardware ne-software niyayibona uba isenje. Inene. Babethonywa aba bantu. Noma siyathena ke be-advertise i-lux neentoni ezosepho zinjalo, noba ibhajethi ayifiki uphelela kwi-life boy, kodwa wawuyithatha ifoto le ube uyigcina. And so on. So ke sisinomxolisi, usafana nalaa mntu andimxhome edonge. Awukabuni. Ndandingaxhomanga inqalo, hayi hayi hayi, usenjalo usenjalo. Yitalente kaAunt Laura ke, she was able to go to townships, villages and take people to the world stage. So ke banta bam, le foundation izothi how do we replicate Aunt Laura in the 21st century. Xana ke ngoku sifika kuvuthondaba, sizawubiza this inaugural board izowusi-introducela ii-board members ezizawuthwala olu xanduva of spreading the pollen ka-Anlora so that the bees, the honey comes out of this, contextualized into the 21st century. Classes are busy ngwayi-ngwayi, uthuse, oyijaji yejaji e-Africa, nowayeproduswe yile ndawo yase Walter Sisulu. Hey, madoda, iprodusile le ndawo. Kana sizawenza loo nto sifuna ukuthi uLes Brown uthi some people die at the age of 18 but they will wait until they are 65 to be buried. Abanye ke uzama ukuthi kukhona abantu abakho bengekho. UAnlora ke is not one of those. Kuba ngoku ndibiza usihlalo wale foundation wokuqala kwawuthiwa yayiqale ngaye umntu wayekho kwi-Truth Commission, umntu wayeke wayivisithela ijeleya lapha eWellington nakwezinye iindawo several times, umntu wayeyi-human rights lawyer, umntu wayekho kwizinto ezininzi, ube ke wayeyo ne-visiting professor e-Connecticut University. Uthusi umntu walapha ecala, safuna ukutshekisha ezidorophu ukuthiwa icala uqumbu ingcobo bazenza njani idorophu inestrati esinye nebhanki enye nejele enye ziproduse abantu abagaga. Masithathe uadvocate Dumisa Ntsebeza utitshala kanjengele owayemtitsha kwesaa sikolo samakhosi aze azosothulela isithethi sethu. Kodwa mandiqale ndazise utata wekhaya wesithethi sekhaya. Ndicela aphakame simqhwabele izandla. Ngusibari we-Eastern Cape wonke lo, siyambanga. Ine bulela kakhulu tata uba nawe you grace the occasion. So let's put our hands together to Ubra D as we introduce our net board members as he is introducing the guest speaker yethu abe selenceda. Xa sebayintrodyusile sifuna bazohlala apha enzela uba sithi xa sesinethiwekha sazi uba ibingobani. Let's put our hands together for Bradi.
Good evening. Yo, hey, I thought there were people here. Good evening, everybody. Oh yeah, that's better. That's better. Yeah. Our program director has done an excellent job of identifying who is here, and which also makes nonsense of my speech, because my speech writer had anticipated that there would be a premiere, there would be this, there would be Selbanzi. You know, but at least Zelbanz is here. I don't know if Dilizindaba was anticipated. Ah, Dilizindaba. But in any event, I will do the job that has been done by the program director in introducing all the dignitaries who are attending this evening. Has been done. I won't go over the people that he identified, and he continues to identify whilst he's here. I have the task, firstly, to announce the official launching of the foundation to the public in my capacity as its first chairperson, and to briefly tell you about what the foundation seeks to achieve. Secondly, I have to introduce to you the board members of the foundation. And lastly, of course, but not least, I am going to introduce the guest speaker. The Andlora Mphahlwa Foundation was established in March 2020 by the Mphahlwa family in honor of what you have now come to know as a well-known businesswoman, community builder, and a stalwart of the Eastern Cape community. In data and beyond. And Andlora Mphahlwa, following her passing on the 1st of June 2019, at the age of 90. The foundation is a non-profit company, and its aims and objectives include, one, preserving the legacy of its patron through various community-based initiatives. Two, promoting the empowerment of women and girls through various programs. Three, supporting some of the key projects she has embarked upon during her illustrious career as a philanthropist and a community builder. Four, promoting the spirit of Ubuntu as embodied by Andlora's legacy through active citizenry. Five, initiating new legacy projects in their name. And sixthly and lastly, launching an autobiography of her life. The foundation itself is founded on five pillars. One, community. Two, business. Three, healthcare. Four, citizenry. And five, education. All of which represent who Andlora was as a pathfinder and as a trendsetter, who straddled all of these lanes effortlessly, almost all of them, without even seeming to try. At this point, I would like to call up the members of the board to the stage. They know themselves. They are already here. The board is made up of a dynamic team of young and not so young men and women who have been carefully handpicked by the Mphahlwa family to be the custodians. I'll repeat that. To be the custodians of the legacy of Andlora. Their qualifications and experience in their respective disciplines speak for themselves, as contained in the program, and I will not read them out of Aberdeen. I will start with the independent board appointees, namely Mr. Asanda Kangule and Ms. Ayanda Khazia. Can they identify themselves by standing up? Standing up. Yeah. Now, both born and raised in Mthatha and attended what was then known as the Mthatha International School, UIS, to which Anlora and I were the founding trustees and members of the school governing body for a number of years. So in the school governing body, Zayo Namshansh, it's what done. Asanda had a very close relationship with Anlora, having been mentored by her in his journey as a young professional, with him being the first head prefect at that then known Mthatha International School. Asanda always saw himself as her last-born son, Andora's last-born son. Ayanda was in the same class as Andora's grandchildren at the Mthatha International School. And their connection with the foundation is through the close ties between the Mpashwa and Khazia families. Both families prominent and deeply entrenched within the Ngambedlana community. The related board appointees, Ms. Mandlakazi Madaka and Laura's only daughter, stand. Ms. Mandlakazi Junior Mpashwa, stand. And Mr. Mongezi Mpashwa, who are the grandchildren. These three individuals have been instrumental in lobbying for the establishment of the foundation and have worked really hard to bring it to where it is today. We're really grateful for all their hard work, including the efforts of the entire board in carrying the legacy of Anlora forward. Now, I'd like to talk a little bit about stakeholder engagement. Since the establishment of the Anlora Mpashwa Foundation, it's about 2 years ago, the board has held numerous stakeholder engagements with various institutions associated with Anlora. The Walter Sisulu University is one such stakeholder, amongst others, which has embraced our proposal to host this inaugural lecture at this Mthatha campus. We're grateful to the Vice Chancellor and the Vice Chancellor's team for making our vision a reality. This, of course, is going to be a yearly event, and therefore we invite similar stakeholders, such as the Mthatha International School, as then was known, the Lukolweni Street Child Organization, Siakana Youth Outreach and Education Program, to mention a few, which were all started by Anlora. We invite them to explore possible areas for collaboration with the foundation and to connect with us. We invite other potential partners to please reach out to us on the contact details contained on the last page of the programming for possible partnerships, which will go a long way in uplifting the people of the Eastern Cape, and so we believe. In keeping with today's theme, Imvuselelo, in the foundation's five pillars, the ones I mentioned earlier on, we envisage a long-term partnership with the Walter Sisulu University in the building and the unveiling of a school of excellence and social entrepreneurship to be named the Anloram Phahlwa School of Excellence and Social Entrepreneurship. We are hoping that that school will be housed at this Mthatha campus of the Walter Sisulu University. At this school, we will be targeting young, talented men and women from the local and surrounding rural areas of the Eastern Cape, offering a well-crafted curriculum focused on enhancing their social life skills, aimed at promoting social activism, entrepreneurship, and leadership. And designed to supplement and advance their chosen career paths. With this curriculum, we will produce an all-rounded graduate that will be fit for purpose and fully equipped to face today's new and emerging challenges, because there are many challenges as each day comes and goes. This will include the establishment of an Anloram Phahlwa Education Fund to be housed and located within the ALM Foundation, ALM meaning Anloram Phahlwa Foundation, aimed at raising funding towards assisting deserving students who will be enrolled at the school. This will be the first of its kind within higher education and will require extensive research and innovation. So watch this space. Of course, these grand and lofty ideas can never be possible without funds, without donors, as they will require a dedicated operational team on the ground with a permanent chief executive officer, CEO. In the capacity the board has made of me, I call upon each and every one of us to reach deep into our pockets and purses to make a contribution towards these grand ideas. It doesn't matter how small the contributions are. The contributions will go a long way in making these ideas a reality. To the captains of industry, business leaders, and indeed our top scholars, we call upon you to help us to keep the spirit and the legacy of Anloram alive for generations to come by supporting our vision. We'd like to thank our sponsors, for their general contribution towards making this evening a resounding success. Each of them, of course, will be acknowledged during that period in the program devoted to vote of thanks. It is now time for me to introduce our guest speaker. Mrs. Gloria Tomato Serobe was born on the 20th of September 1959 to a Gugule to Cape Town based family. Intombi yakwaNdaliso. They were originally from that part of the Eastern Cape called Transkei and from that rural area called Kutendane. And yet from that Kutendane, there came a woman who became one of the founding members and chief executive officer of something called WIPHOLD, WIPHOLD, all of them in capital letters. Think to me, will have to tell us by Melendonan, but I know that it is what it was supposed to be. Their experience over a almost four decades in the corporate world. Ms. Robe has held positions at, amongst other places, Transnet. Transnet. Yes, I'm sorry. The Exxon Corporation in the USA, Munich Re Insurance Company of South Africa, the Premier Group, and Standard Corporate and Merchant Bank. Her experience in corporate governance has also seen her appointed to a number of national and multinational boards as chairman. As a leader in the business world, activist for community upliftment, the empowerment of women, and the sustainable transformation of the South African economic landscape, Ms. Serobe has received many honorary degrees and various awards. She is a proud alumna of this university, where she completed a BCom degree. She also holds an MBA degree from Rutgers University in New Jersey in the USA. In 2023, she became a published author. Of a book called An Ode to My Mother-in-Law, A Mentorship of Love and Honor. I'm sure Mr. Serobe is taking note of this. An Ode to My Mother-in-Law, A Mentorship of Love and Honor. Obviously, she's married to Mrs. Robert. I don't want to pronounce this word, G-A-U-R, because I don't want to do murder to the pronunciation of the word. But he's here with us. He was introduced earlier during the program. Yeah. It's a pleasure to meet you again, sir. Tomato has one son, Zani, Serobe. Indeed, my speechwriter said, indeed, to Ms. Serobe is the epitome of who Anvlora was. An epitome of who Anvlora was. Ladies and gentlemen, without further ado, let it be my pleasure to invite Ms. Gloria Serobe to the stage to deliver the inaugural memorial lecture of the Anvlora Mphahlwa Foundation. And it is permitted.
Working together, no Professor Mfenyana, no Professor Luswazi, no Professor Maswai. Bema, the city, now city of our university. How can you close a big river? How sell up about one of us about 10 genie? Where mum take and papa? Umfason a little when you said this is where. Nam Shazia City, the Perth University produce a lot of leaders in the South Africa. Otat, Abakokela, Abapumagle University, Amakweta, Apumizacha, Pumagle University, Okliha, Abangopoto, Shachuba, Pumagle University, Guano Nobangela, Walonto, Kulong Fasu, Abatepu, Bakango, Sakam Kupukain. Umama kamandisi. Hayi bantwana bam, okwenu sendi ubonile, oyenu msamu sendi usamile. Toto kwa nini, toto sbehu, toto tehula, toto hringwa, toto malebofu, ube mutepe sili, wale fangisi. Diani bwana nonke. Yambeka nomkebe ngela xesha wayedubula kakhulu elijoni esilwele esisizwe sakokwethu kodwa bonke abantu abalapha they have got nothing to do without Auntie Laura nofafalude into enobusobo utamtam ngathi ziibhutu zomntwana nantsi inkwenkwente madoda engu-deputy speaker of the province iphuma kule yunivesithi mntakalo swazi I'll never forget about what you've done for the community of this world ndizibonele zizwe abantwana baseSt John's bantwana bam the only university I can say you leave this world at this university to other universities. Abondo Santi we moto hotel baphuma kule university mtakafikene ndandingaqondi ndandicimba ngowaseNigeria support talk me that you have born from kumaXesibe oba nantsika ibheka nje kumntwana wotso wotso Aunt Laura wotso kazini yarhaha kwibhutulo zabathakathi namhla siyatsho sithi yentsebeza yadumisa njengoba ukhokhele le nto esiyibiza ngoba yi-foundation ingathathi iminyaka emibini kowesithathu seyitshabaleyo. I know you are a leader by birth not by nominated manyawuza kubizwa wena bimbitsono ndinya kulo mpombo ntondine ngophula amadoda imiqolo xa ingabelekwa khazi liyarhaka kwibhutulu zabathakathi sicemba naxolo uthi mathumba le hapu ingabangakho ke na thumba senyangelezi senekwasingomi. You are here today as a guest speaker for this foundation the family of Thembu badisayide ngabakhetha wena. Why? It's because what they saw from you. Your husband decided to choose you to all the beautiful women. Wakonduba, ayikho into enhle emdaka ngathi inkomo yamanzi egqitha wena, wathatha wena. Tell us, where are we going from now? You know that the politician are gonna do something on the 20-something. Bazawulwa ke mntana egazi. Kala mhlandu waziyo mna ndodwa athomnye ngum athomnye ndim athomnye ngum athomnye ndim athomnye ngum athomnye ndim kodwa sizawuphuma ebhantini say the best and the truth the best organization can lead this nation not to hell as far as I'm concerned. Abanye bayale abanye bayale mna ndiyagothuka Deram, Ken Chotamolo,
Hakakamolo. program director, as the chairman of the foundation has said, you've made it easy for us to say all protocol observed. You've done a wonderful job. But Utatunga Ngomhlaba Mathanzima told me why thina singomama we are not expected to kahle. Why explain kahle le nto kum? So ndiba comfortable xa sihleli phansi. I don't feel that we are disrespectful. But I still have to say, Kumkani, it is so wonderful to have you here, and we do recognize you. But the only people in Zaba Kashel and Amplange, if you allow me, Highland Dad. Highland Dad! Of course, man. Yes. Yes. I was so excited to see them, Chairman. I must thank the family for making sure that they are here. I am a student of St. John's. In fact, if the principal had warned me, I would have put on my blazer too. I've got it. They've made my size as well. It fits. We were the first of the 5 girls to go to St. John's. It was a boys' school then. We survived, here we are. Here is our voice. So I'm quite excited to see you. I have to specifically acknowledge, because we're going to go back home after this, I have to acknowledge my husband of 37 years. He has made sure to come and look at how come amadoda lovers is shumani kangaka. Nje nje ehawuthi ndofuna umyeni. Kodwa ke, it is a benefit now. And acknowledge specifically Wendy, one of my co-founders of Whiphold, which is 30 years old now. It is my greatest pleasure, and I do wish to express my sincere appreciation and gratitude for the honor extended to me by the Ann Laura Foundation and Walter Sisulu University to deliver the first memorial lecture dedicated to Ann Laura. I also want to congratulate the foundation for the wisdom to decide to partner with the Walter Sisulu University, not because I am made of this university. But that's one of the reasons. I must congratulate them. But Walter Sisulu University has delivered the best of intellectual brains possible to our country in its 47 years of existence. And two of which, interesting enough, your chancellor, Nonkululeko Gobodo, is the first black woman to qualify as a chartered accountant. Your chairman of the council, Advocate Thembeka Ngcobayi Thobi, is one of the finest legal brains in the country, who proudly recently represented us in the ICJ court case. And for the first time, I was comfortable with that hair of his. Because the substance of a form, right? He's one of you here. He's done his BProc and LLB here. But this university has given us all manner of general. Ungan Piki, I was in class with you. Don't disown me. Yes. And you were in uniform. Sasukoyega great. And many other top minds of this country. I was so excited to see a lot of justices here. I was asking Justice Madlanga, can you just tell me how many of the judges we have got just from this university? He could not give me that number. So I think the foundation, you've been very calculated to actually decide to partner with the Walter Sisulu University. In 4 days' time, on the 31st of March 2024, it will be Ann Laura's 95th birthday, having been born in 1929. South Africa then was unimaginably different to what it is today. We could never imagine the levels of oppression under which millions of people lived. It was also the year, incidentally, in which the National Party under James Barry Munich Herzog won on an outright majority in their House of Assembly. In the run-up to this moment in history, various pieces of legislation had been passed that systematically excluded black people from the political and economic life of the country. With this political development, however, the scene was set for the escalation of the period, which was characterized by people, black people, increasingly rejecting this systematic exclusion through, amongst others, the formation of the SACP, the ANC's adoption of the Bill of Rights at its National Conference General, UDM was not there yet. I will come back to that. Nkosi Sikelel' Afrika is its anthem, and the flag with the black, green, and gold representing the people, the mineral and land wealth of the country, and a range of protests throughout the country. 1929 was also the year in which the world went into a Great Depression, and South Africa did not escape its economic effects. And so it was into this economic, political, and social contract that Ann Laura was born. In the face of such need, deprivation, and exclusion, the spirit of activism and service was inculcated in her from the earliest days. We met Ann Laura and experienced her quite early in our teens, in the late 70s, as a student at St. John's College. For us then, she was just a young mother in her 40s who decided to play this parenting role to us, because we came from everywhere else. But for her, with hindsight, it turns out we were yet another project of hers, grooming us for bigger things and being the future that she saw for this country. I can safely say, Ann Laura, we didn't disappoint you. There's many of us. We did the right thing by you. We just didn't understand. We're just following you. As a mother, it turns out you were playing a particular game, which at 17 years old at that time, we didn't know much about. We were a little bit dumb than the current student. Politics is as a late move. At that time, we're just naive children. And we just saw this mother who's playing his cougars and doing all those nice things, but she was grooming us for the greater things. The theme of this lecture is Imvuselelo, the rebirth of active citizenry and giving birth to our communities to strengthen democracy. Mindful that I will be delivering this lecture to a combination of people in academics, scholars, business people, politicians, students, and all types of leaders, I had to find the theoretical framework in which to place Anlora, which can become a takeaway for further intellectual digesting. The theory that I found applicable to Anlora is the social entrepreneurship theory. According to Bill Drayton, the founder and CEO of Ashoka, social entrepreneurs inspire images of audacious change, the kind that sweeps away the old approaches to solve intractable social problems, such as disease, hunger, and poverty. Social entrepreneurs involves a way of creative destruction that remakes society. This seems to describe Anlora. She was a disruptor. Two of the world's most famous social entrepreneurs, one is Mohamed Yunus. He is an 84-year-old, a Bangladeshi social entrepreneur who was awarded the Nobel Peace Prize in 2006 for founding the Grameen Bank, and he pioneered the concept of microcredit and microfinance. The second famous social entrepreneur is Bill Drayton. He is the founder of Ashoka based in the US. Ashoka identifies, connects, and supports the world leading social entrepreneurs, learns from the patterns in their innovations, and mobilizes a global community that embraces these new frameworks to build what he called everyone is a change maker. He is responsible for the rise of this phrase of social entrepreneur in 1972. What is our understanding of Anlora then in this context? She was a nurse by profession who qualified at the Pretoria Ashfield Hospital in the early 1950s. Born in 1929 to Elder Msiman, she was brought up by her grandparents, John and Lina Mbanza, in Doornfontein, Johannesburg. When the Group Areas Act was enacted into law, her grandparents were forcibly removed from the city center into a three-room house in Orlando Township in Soweto. Equipped with her nursing qualification, she moved to Umtata in the early 1950s. This became the base from which she launched all her activities, which seemed to be her attempt to deal with the underlying dynamics of the apartheid system. Typical of her social entrepreneur character, instead of treating the society distress, mainly due to the cruel apartheid policy implementation, she instead held hope for eliminating the distress altogether. I have grouped all her life activities at least into four categories, the first one being education. So Anlora contributed meaningfully to the social needs of the community in Umtata. She was instrumental in raising funds for the establishment of Sibabalwe Training Center for the disabled people in North Crest, a project born out of, say, Henry Elliott Hospital in Umtata, where she had worked as a young nurse in 1953. She further championed the establishment of two institutions for children who were homeless the Elukolweni School and the Siyakhana program. Both these institutions provided shelter to children who do not have a place to go, and where they would be assisted with attending school, getting some meals and other basic needs. She further sourced land and funding for the establishment of various schools, at which she would play a key role as member of the school governing body. When the only existing previously white English medium school in Umtata refused access to a lot of children, a committee was formed by the parents, including Aunt Laura, which led to the establishment of Umtata International School, which became the first black privately owned English medium school in Umtata, and proudly attended by her own grandchildren. She also established the Ezra Skwela Junior Secondary School in Ngangelizwe, which was built for the children of an informal settlement called Etipini. I have to mention all these things because this is now a lecture. It's going to be filed. Somebody must go into file and understand who Aunt Laura is. In this context, you can see that social entrepreneurs appear to make quite deliberate decisions to solve social problems, rather than simply stumbling into their work by accident. They are often quite sober about their decisions to attack a social problem, and they usually understand the consequences of challenging the status quo. They are driven by a persistent, almost unshakable optimism. They persevere in large part because they truly believe that they will succeed in spite of messages to the contrary. This optimism is essential to their 24 hours a day kind of commitment. The next category where Aunt Laura even us, she confused us, was fashion and beauty. Yes, she ran the flagship family business in Umtata with her husband, which was named Aunt Laura's Fashion Boutique. It is, however, the establishment of Miss Transcal Beauty Pageant that was created and confused us, because we were at St. John's. We believed that only medicine science is important. And Aunt Laura actually taught us that this too, this sector, is important. Those winners were afforded the opportunity of a lifetime to participate in the Miss Universe International Beauty Pageant, an eye-opener to experience other countries and cultures. Clearly, for the acceptance of Miss Transkei into the International Miss Universe, it meant Aunt Laura had to travel the world to make a case for the Miss Transkei representation. These activities were a way to encourage and celebrate black beauty and dignity of the young women, beauty with a purpose. So, Professor, I do not doubt one reason why you had Nomkhonso on your walls, and I'm sure you were not the only one. And I think still today, Nomkhonso is still on people's walls. She was pretty then, she's pretty now, but extremely bright. And that's the part we missed, that Aunt Laura was trying to make sure that we don't lose this part in the sense of beauty. In this case, you then see that social entrepreneurs are bold and audacious, and their ideas are big with grand impacts. The third category is on health. Her choice of nursing as a profession further enabled her to serve her community. Being a nurse in South Africa during the height of apartheid was much a contribution to the country as being a freedom fighter. Black people were excluded from the formal healthcare system, which offered only the most basic of services. Mother and infant mortality, as well as a range of other preventable healthcare issues, were rife in the community. Nurses were pillars of the society in the face of so much need. Had she not already had that spirit of service and activism in her during her training at that hospital, she met Mama Adelaide Tambo. And as they say, the rest is history. She was to spend the rest of her life devoted to working for the liberation of people from conditions of poverty and inequality. Yet community organization was in her blood, and in the May 2000, she and other retired nurses formed the Retired Healthcare Personnel Organization under the theme, Retired But Not Tired. Tired but not tired. Which ran health awareness and gardening projects in communities around Umtata. Using her nursing qualification, Anlora decided to make these strong interventions in the health sector, especially working with the university. Appointed her as a member of the Medical Research Council, coming from this part of the country, was a major breakthrough, given the extreme poverty-related diseases that are found here. Being part of that research, that innovation, that development, and technology transfer to improve the health of the people of South Africa. In this regard, you will see Anlora explaining the question that social entrepreneurs are desperate for impact on the communities they serve. Then under politics, Anlora was not spared the effects of the wrath and power of the apartheid regime. She suffered under its oppressive laws, and her home was also raided many times. Yet she continued to work for the liberation from the deeply oppressive regime, helped people escape into exile, and used her family's boutique as a cell for political meetings. So if you go there and you are the apartheid police, people think people are shopping for clothes, it turns out it's a cell for political meeting. Her children were equally not spared by the regime. And one of her sons had to flee into exile, and another even served time on Robben Island. Yet Anlora was of a generation where service was part of their DNA. At the same time, she embodied the spirit of President Mandela's words when he famously said, "It is an ideal for which I hope to live for and to achieve. But if needs be, it is an ideal for which I am prepared to die." Such was the conviction of the cohort of South Africans of which Anlora was a part. They kept going for the greater good, even at personal cost to themselves and their families. There was no sacrifice too big or small for the South Africa of their dreams and hopes, the South Africa they wished their children, grandchildren, and all generations to come could enjoy. Social entrepreneurs keep going for the greater good, even at personal cost to themselves and their families. And the last of the pillars around Anlora is her emphasis on family values and the generations of scholars. Her expectation, even from us, was that we would be these families that will produce generations and generations of scholars. I do not blame her. This region is known for scholar families. That is what this province is known for. So I am imagining that Anlora being a possibility of
creating generations and generations of scholars despite of our apartheid environment, which main objective was to deprive us of education. She might have been inspired by the family of Soga, the legacy, or even closer home, the one that came to mind is the Tawa family here in Willowvale. In 1829, 100 years before Anlora was born, Reverend Joe Soga was born to a traditional family in rural Eastern Cape and became the first black to go to school. Following the Scottish missionaries who were his mentors, he ended up as a famous scholar at the University of Glasgow in Scotland in literature and theology. He is amongst his many achievements very much associated with the famous hymn Lizali Sitingalapo, which he composed. But the biggest legacy Joe Soga left behind for South Africa is very much through his two children, William Anderson Soga and Jodelo Festery Soga. According to the late Professor Bongani Mayosi, the cardiologist and dean of the Faculty of Health Sciences at UCT, Dio Soga's firstborn son, William Anderson Soga, became the first black doctor in South Africa, having qualified in Glasgow in 1883, 30 years before UCT established its medical school and 60 years before Wits and UCT accepted blacks into their medical faculties in 1941. This inspired several doctors who came after him, like Dr. Moroka, Dr. Kuma, Dr. Montenegro, and Dr. Yusuf Dadu. Between 1918 and 1934, they all qualified overseas and mainly at the University of Edinburgh, given that Wits and UCT only accepted black medical students after 1941. And they all went on to become famous and contributed immensely to our country. Dr. Moroka and Dr. Kuma became successive presidents of the ANC, while Dr. Naika revived the Natal Indian Congress and Dr. Yusuf Dadu became the leader of the Transvaal Indian Congress and leader of the SACP. This comes back to one family can switch on the light and create a massive positive destruction of the status quo. They left an enormous legacy in South Africa's field of medical science and health, which has become one of the most highly regarded internationally. So when in 2020 COVID showed up all over the world, it became very clear that each country was going to have to depend on itself and be led by its own scientists for solutions. As the chairman of the Solidarity Fund for COVID Response in South Africa, I'm very proud to say for scientific and intellectual direction in this battle zone, we relied on the COVID-19 response team under the leadership of our own very own Professor Salim Karim, followed by Professor Kolega Mlisana from here in Bazia, the product of the former Black Medical School at the University of Natal. South Africa has been applauded by the World Health Organization and the rest of the world for the manner in which we handled the pandemic. Such is the strong legacy that Tio Soga and William Anderson Soga left behind within medicine and health. This seems to be Ann Laura's dream, that there will be many of these families like this to make a change in South Africa. It was Tio Soga's other son, though, Dr. Jodelo Soga, who became the first ever South African of any race to receive a degree in veterinary science. In 1886, he qualified at Edinburgh College of Medicine and Veterinary Medicine as a member of the Royal College of Veterinary Surgeons with a gold medal distinction in botany. After coming back home to South Africa, he helped eradicate rinderpest, a highly contagious and fatal cattle disease that almost decimated South Africa's cattle stock. For the next 26 years until 1912, he was the only veterinary surgeon of any color in South Africa. And so besides his influence in theology and literature, Tio Soga left behind a huge legacy in these two areas, in medicine and in agriculture. What does that say about Andorra? Social entrepreneurs have an obsession with family values and generational legacies, especially education, because they want to leave something behind long after they have left. The foundation asked me to answer a specific question. How do we emulate an Andorra in these times? And they asked me to give a case study which they believe would be the case study of what is happening at Nkwentane and Mpashe in terms of that agricultural project. The theme of this lecture is Imvuselelo, the rebirth of active citizenry and giving birth to our communities to strengthen democracy. And so this case in Nkwentane and Mpashe is an interesting whipple case study of how Andorra can be replicated and more, especially given that as this generation we have better access to resources, financial and otherwise, in terms of networks, with the same focus and determination that she used, we can do a lot more to change our country. Why did we pick on Mpashe and Mwoma to do this project? Tendane and Willowby, never mind that Tendane is lucky that I was born there, but Tendane and Willowby have got a rich history of the Khoisans. Reverend Tio Soga, I've just spoken about, is buried in Tutuka in Tendane. And in 2020, we had to build a monument on his gravesite, given his importance in our history. King Phalo, the Khoisa king, is buried in Mbawa between Tendane and Butterworth. Even the infamous Nongqawuse happened in Tendane now, the great cattle killing in 1856. Even though it embarrasses us, but you can't rewrite history. Nongqawuse is our history now. One of the famous battles in the country is Tendane Hill Battle. This was made famous because it was the first time two kings were in the same battle, King Sahile and King Sandile. King Yinza is buried here in Ngadu, and King Sahile is buried on the Mpashe River. Why am I boring you with this? All this history is not known because it is buried under this deliberate poverty by the apartheid system. And so we also sought to unlock this rich history by first removing this poverty from the system. Mwoma and Mpashe district are the poorest districts in South Africa. At some stage, Tendane and Ellodale were competing for number one and number two in terms of the poorest towns in the country. Yet the biggest asset of these communities is land, however without title deeds. This makes their crucial asset not bankable due to a lack of security of tenure, and this in turn perpetuates the poverty. And so with this focus in mind, WIPOL decided to take this on community problem in the Andorra way, by changing it in a way that is not reversible.
We partnered with the community of Nqoma and Mbashe, and we partnered with the traditional leaders. With that, we were also trying to show our colleagues in corporate sector that rural development can't happen without the traditional leadership system inside it. You can have your political views about it, but the traditional leadership system is real in the rural areas. And there are a leadership system that is in that community. We partnered with this community and these traditional leaders and used this land without title deeds and pushed the boundaries. And so, 10 years ago, we pulled NetBank and Old Mutual went ahead with an investment of 100 million rands, each party contributing 33 million rands, and began the maize and soya bean project in the Mbashe and Nqoma municipality on land which had no title deeds. With these partners having absorbed the initial risks and demonstrating what can be done, other corporate entities came on board with this project, having found a commercially viable platform to support. I must also recognize here that the participation of the Eastern Cape Rural Development made it possible. Their presence in this project cannot be overestimated. And so today, collectively, we have 2,500 hectares of land under production, with 2,800 landowners in the project. Landowners are treated as such with proper rental and then participation in the year-end income. The project covers 39 villages in Nqoma and Mbashe, from Kolohe and Tutuha to Kafdweni, Gwadana, Madu, Willowville, you name it. The project has 2,800 bank accounts, meaning the money goes directly to the landowners and not via some committees. AFGRI has donated 15,000 tons of bunker storage and a maize dry into the project. This is very important because the lack of storage facility in this region is problematic. They also manage it on behalf of us because it's a sophisticated project. This is the first ever, MEC, you can confirm, this is the first ever commercial storage facility for the Eastern Cape and is a significant catalyst for change in the program. We are following the same modus operandi with the livestock and also piggybacking on the government. But a decade later, I can tell you, this community will never be the same again. And more than anything else, their dignity and self-esteem is back, has been restored. Lastly, on rural development, it requires heavy lifting. The small and subsistence farming is not going to move a dime given the size of the problem. The change needs to be substantial and irreversible. Mongezi, in the foundation, asked me to address the last point of how do we get the youth to act like an Andlora. According to UNESCO, youth are one of Africa's greatest reasons for optimism because 70% of the continent's population is under 30. Meantime, in 2016, a poll of young adults between ages 18 and 29, conducted by experts at Harvard University, just 42% say they support the current economic system, while 51% say they do not. This is critical. The millennials, as we call them, do not trust
the current mainstream economic system. While this was a big surprise, according to Mohamed Yunus, it is the poverty, unemployment, and inequality that this young generation is experiencing under this economic system that makes them unhappy. This was surprising, come as it did from the youth of some of the wealthiest countries. South African youth, on the other hand, have an added burden of our expectations that they must help us undo all the social ills that were entrenched by the apartheid policies. We expect them to deliver on transformation, plowing back, help us rearrange the fortunes of this country. Because they have better opportunities and possibilities, we expect them to do better than us or the generations before us. They have better tools and equipment and platforms that they can use as instruments for change. Some are in serious positions of leadership, both in private sector and public sector. The question then arises as to how can we get our youth to act like Andlora? How do we get them back to this active citizenry mode? The benefit we had as my generation is that we had experienced and lived our adult lives under apartheid and under the constitutional democracy. We will do anything to make sure that period is never ever repeated. So it comes natural to us. We're so scared of that period. But we also had the privilege of being mentored and lived under the leadership of the stalwarts of change. O Andlora, Mamsimang, O Mangadime, Makotane, Masisulu. We have experienced them in our lives. We were never short of living role models. 30 years since the dawn of democracy, the history and knowledge of this evil system is starting to fade. Unless we deliberately engage on this subject, the youth might not have enough to work with or even know what we're trying to reverse. Some of the stories are ridiculous. They can't believe that to go to a university we needed the permission of a minister of something. But those are the stories, and those stories are disappearing. Mohamed Yunus, in his book of A World of Three Zeros, does address the matter of how he tried to answer the question of how to energize the youth into being social entrepreneurs in an Andlora way. Universities in all continents are establishing Yunus social business centers to teach courses, undertake research, and to act as clearinghouses for social business ideas for business leaders, foundations, NGOs, social activities, government organizations, and financial institutions. By now, over 34 universities all over the world have Yunus centers. It might then be that Advocate Zebeza, the chairman of the foundation, to energize our youth back to active citizenry, we might need centers like the Andlora centers, with an angle that keeps the memory and knowledge of how the apartheid system worked in South Africa and its impact that is going to take many generations to correct. But what maybe I would want to tweak on your plans is, yes, the base can be Walter Sisulu University, but Andlora now belongs to the country. Andlora's center has got to be everywhere where there's a center of learning. And it has to be done while we still remember her and all that energy. We must recall that when Andlora and her cohort of citizens stood up and to be counted, they were just ordinary people living through the same conditions as other people. They were not extraordinarily advantaged economically or socially, but would not stand by and do nothing in the face of such need. This is the activism that is required in this contemporary age, a spirit of working together for win-win solutions and jointly beneficial outcomes. That spirit is also crucial to ensuring that we build our country together. Public representatives, citizens, and business. There is an African proverb that goes, if you want to go fast, go alone. If you want to go far, go together. Building a nation is not an easy endeavor. Creating a spirit of oneness wherein different identities remaining intact is difficult, even in a country without the fractures we have had to endure. 30 years is a short time in the lifespan of a country. In our 30 years, some things have gone well and others have gone badly. But nothing is irreversible with the will to do things differently. We must join together our individual sense of pride and patriotism so that we can ensure we turn around the trajectory of our country. Our collective spirit to serve will be the driver and the critical success factor. So as we gather here today, a few days before the 95th birthday of Fair Ann Laura, we have an opportunity to consider this point very deeply. And more importantly, we have an opportunity to make a different choice about how we build our country. And let me also say, we will not build our country on hashtags and social media outrage. We need to organize ourselves so that we can address the real issues through hard work, perseverance, and commitment. Ladies and gentlemen, and to the family of Ann Laura who are present, the legacy of Ann Laura will cast a long shadow of our country and the community of Umtata in particular. I hope that this shadow will infuse in us the spirit of active citizenship, the sense of leading to serve, and the humanity to want to build a better South Africa. The work we have collectively done till now has helped us to set us on a different path, but it has not been nearly as sufficient as required. This 30th anniversary of democracy must serve to inspire us to do more, to do differently, and contribute wherever we can. We must be prepared to step up and contribute. There can be no other way to build our country. And it is our country, and therefore it must be our responsibility. To conclude, the state has expressed itself on this social entrepreneur by awarding her the National Orders of Luthuli in 2021. You can't do better than that. Business has spoken. They've given her business awards. Civil society has also spoken. They've given her community awards. Universities have also spoken. These honorary doctorates that they have given her. What is left is for Ann Laura Centers for the rebirth of active citizenry, which must be established right through the country. I want to thank you again for this opportunity, and I wish the Mpatla family well as you commemorate the birthday of what you claim to be your mother, but what we claim to be our mother. Thank you.
Wow. This is a clarion call. This is a call to the battlefront of development. It cannot be clearer than that. Let's put our hands together again. It is the impact of this speech that is causing even the microphones to fall. Wow. We sometimes get the temptation of despair, but today we came to ignite hope. We came to keep hope alive. Wow. Now, after the speech, I'm convinced that we were listening to Anlora of the 21st century. Heaven built on Anlora of the 20th century. And to these young ones, you are the leaders we've been waiting for. Let's say cheers to yourselves. You just made this case of social entrepreneurship so compelling, so enticing, so inviting. I just noted one thing. Anlora have gone to join the ages. She was born exactly the same year as Martin Luther King Jr. So they are having a nice conversation on the other side. And it is that Martin Luther King Jr. who said, even though we may face the difficulties of today and tomorrow, I still have a dream. What is our dream today? She came to outline it. There are people like Professor Luswazi here who we know as having been that Amazon soldier facing Kadar Smal during those years when Kadar Smal wanted to wish this place to no existence. But she has moved on now to be a warrior for Ilima Labantu Rural Development Project. And I want to say on the 21st of March, a few days ago, in a meeting attended by us and Dr. Luyanda Mpatwa, Ilima said, Nati, we want to partner with the Anlora Foundation for Rural Development. Bandaba Njengo Prof. Luswazi, when you can ignore them, you can wish them away, but what they did and the footprint just refuse to go away. And please, I was told earlier on that you fill some attendance register so that the auditors know that we did not have ghost attendees. We really had people. So if you feel that, it will really be nice. Now we're moving towards the end. We have messages from our Prof. Ngusu. We have messages from our Dr. Brigalia Bam. Mama Brigalia Bam, each functional, we are going to Brigadier Bam. And I can see that she's competing for that position in the military. And we even have a message from Old Mutual. These partners coming on board will be very helpful. And as such, there's a very short message that Uyanda will speak to that. Ninga ilibali na last page where we can make pledges. It can be now, it can be after Ipasika, because I know some people There's one story of an old man who promised out of excitement, what if nakule pasi ke zayinkomo izawuphuma kwam. Kanti usaza yocela ebantwaneni babantu bam. This committee, labantwana, they were not bulging. Now umuntu omdala uphethwe intloko kuba kaloku ipasi iyasondela abefundisi bamani besithi asizuba sazihlupha ngento yokuxhela kuba utata ubani ubeseye wazibika. Utata ubani akanayo nenye inkomo esibayene kodwa ke ithemba libulali. Now masicele usis Ayanda enze lo message mfutshane ka Old Mutual as we are preparing for a vote of thanks. After that there will be networking session. Khona I banking details, khona I contact details for partnership. Sometimes you sit in a certain agency okanye ngu MEC une programs ezithile okanye you will just become an Elon Musk kwaba bantu batsha qhamke nje nento entsha. Zungayilibali le initiative because it's touching lives. Sis Ayanda, who could not to read this message? Yabona ke usis Ayanda. Noba wayefunde international landa kwakukhunyushwa ngendlela engumangaliso. Kodwa zange bade bafike kulaa ndawo kuthiwa xa kuthi umntwana makafunde iBhayibhile athi daru daru bawo. Kanti uzama ukuthi tahu tahu. Engazange akathi I'm from Razia family. Xa izama ukuthi Razia, over to you.
Good evening, everyone. I'd like to acknowledge everyone here with us today and all protocols observed. I'd like to firstly acknowledge the representatives that we have from Old Mutual, and there's a message that they've asked the foundation to deliver on behalf of Old Mutual. It reads as follows. On behalf of Old Mutual, a company with its roots deeply entrenched in South Africa for 178 years, and with corporate social responsibility embedded in our culture, we are very proud to be one of the sponsors and supporters of this program, in celebration and honor of Aunt Laura Mphahlwa, her foundation, and the impactful work that they do. In support of this inaugural event's theme of Imvuselelo, the rebirth of active citizenry and giving back to our communities to strengthen democracy, we too are committed to driving active citizenry in partnership with government, civil society, and the private sector that enables us all to contribute to a meaningful transformation in South Africa and across the continent. Through the effective support of socio-economic initiatives and collaborative efforts, we're able to create economically viable communities and empower and enable people to access livelihoods and dignity. As a responsible corporate citizen, we recognize the need to partner strategically with our beneficiaries, the government, civil societies, and the private sector to drive long-term sustainable development for the benefit of all. We understand that as South Africans, we have a duty to actively engage in shaping the country we want to live in. We are truly honored and inspired to be among such greatness here today. The champions of the people and change, and those committed to making a positive difference as we strive towards a common goal for inclusivity, active citizenry, social equity, fairness, justice, and equality. We look forward to growing, nurturing, and building on a collaborative partnership approach going forward, so that together we can all champion mutually positive futures every day. Thank you.
We have the sister Ka and Laura Mphahlwa. Owendele ngaphevenda. Uze nefamily yakhe yakwaDombo. Shukuthi when I was saying the Madegwane, I was hoping that they would say the Madegwane abuti. Ndizothi nam ndodiwuwa. Kuba kaloku kulaa ndawo yile ndawo yemengo nefruithi nantoni awubisadlulecha kuma to buy some fruit. Very generous people. Let's see them and put our hands together for them. Bala. Uyabona nje uba zinkondekazi ezi. They are seasoned veterans. Wow. Bona ke mna ndilihambe kakhulu ela cala oomandala novufudi onjelele. Ey, zindawo zamezo. Without any waste of time, sizawufumana ngokuncothu mazangwa so that we can absorb this beautiful message that we heard, so that we can seal into our minds and hearts the message of a social entrepreneur, the message on how do we plant this mustard seed, which is Laura Mphahlwa, so that it multiplies within us. Ngelke shikwayara iphakama. Zenithi ke nobani esipasikeni. Go tell them that this foundation is born. Nokuba ulungiselela amazwi asixhenxe, kuthwe uyashumayela, find a way. Noba kuthwe ndiyanxanwa, ufake nje imessage yefoundation. Let's put our hands together for the choir.
Oh,
Magvala on such a strong note. Let's put our hands together. Ukubani sayikhumbula iUNITRA choir eyayithi yakushukuma apha kube ngathi kuzawuwisilingi nisike nandikhumbuza emva. Okokuqala ndifuna ukuthi xa ndizawuhla kule ndawo kumntu ngamnye endithe andambiza akusikuba kuthiwa ungeneno kunomnye. Into okunayo izinto ziyenzeka xana abantu bengumbo nomxesibe. Ndingumxesibe ke mna ningabambonini kuba kaloku ndiyababona apha umngani wam apha umntakahoboyi who became one of the youngest shareholders kwinto ye-mining. Kodwa ndandidibene nabo ngelo xesha kusenzima kwi-unions. Ndisebenza nabo kwimicimbi yenumu nezinye. Ndahoboyi. Kuthiwa ulapha nefemeli kumam wam uMaga balapha nabanye abantu. Yazi xa sekuleli xesha ii-data bundles zam zokuthetha isilungu ziyehla ndihlele esiXhoseni. Nakuya kusihlwa undibone sendixela ndixela isiXesibe. So nindinyamezele nefemeli yakwaMthongana siyibonile apha. Let's put our hands together for nefemeli yakwaBhacela community yaseNcambedlana. Ndawo enkulu yaseNcambedlana ndihlale iminyaka eNcambedlana after I was banished from my residences zalapha ngendaba yedoyidoyi ndaso sendangumhlali waseNorwood naseNcambedlana. Now, all having been said and done, xana ndizawunikezela kwi-vote of thanks umbulelo kunyana welikhaya ubhuti Luyanda uGqirha Mphahlwa Fafolude. Ngabantu ke aba baseRobben Island not through tourism. Waye ngolwa hlobo lowuvela uzibone sowupha engunyana walapha ekhaya uzawuza ezo nibulela ninonke. You've been such a wonderful audience. Kodwa kubo bonke ngathi ngasiphinda sithi kodada azwelibanzi, azwelibanzi, azwelibanzi. Okokuba ikumkani sizolele ibe nomdla omngaka kule nto. Xa ndimbhekile umzukulwana kaGube Ngcuka ingathi seyipatna yale foundation. Masibethele izandla loo ndawo. Nene. Seyipatna kuba le nto ingangelizwe. Ingaphezu kwethu sonke. Kukhona i-music item eseyisicwabile ke ngoku yabe seyisibizela uDr. Luyanda Mphahlwa. And I just want to say you've been such a wonderful, wonderful audience. And I want to say if not now, when will we do it? If not here, where? If not you, who will do it? Thank you.
Good evening, Molweni. And as bands of Kalabs. But it is a great honor and privilege that the family has granted me the opportunity to be the one who presents the vote of thanks. But before I do that, I do want to echo what our program director has said, that today we have not only listened, but we have actually witnessed how the new generation of professionals have risen up to the challenge of articulating what we all are seeking to find and to resolve and to address. Sis Gloria, bengumzana wethu, hayi lentaka. Before I say anything, it has to be my greatest pleasure to acknowledge you as being among the first five girls who came to St. John's sing our boys to see Sodwa. And we were in my group of boys, we were your bodyguards, if you remember. So I think it's a great pleasure that we can be in on these platforms. Thank you very much. But yeah, I'm still gonna come back. Ladies and gentlemen, the program director has taken my thunder of having to acknowledge Kumkani, which I think we have. We are so grateful that Kumkani spent the evening with us. Siyabulela. And in terms of protocol, I have to acknowledge the role which Iphondo has played. The Premier, having apologized, but Uthumelo MEC, who has played her role during the funeral to assist us, ekubekeni umama, and today she has come to support us once again. So we appreciate this, MEC, on behalf of the Premier. I protocol gandi bambi ngam, but I have to acknowledge the fact that it's not Deputy Speaker, Koboshiane. I know there's always an issue, province, national, but no, if the putila, someone they'll understand. I'd like to acknowledge Unjengele. Unjengele ke ulanto yoba kusithwa wayebhukuqa apha. Wayephinde afune i-advice from the elders, ootata. And wayehlala nawo lamaxhego, ndithi ndibuyile ndise-exile. Ndibuye exile, ndifike ehleli namaxhego phaa oomphahla, oombambisa, oogobodo. Bemcoach. Zange ndithi ke bathi makayobhukuqa, kodwa ke it looks like ikhona into ayifundayo phaa kubo. I have to acknowledge uDilizwe Ntaba. Ah, Dilizwe Ntaba. I-product yaseSt John's. Hayi le ntaka. Thank you so much. I have to acknowledge that E-Ward 8, which Umama served in her capacity as a member of the ANC, ithumele abantu abayi 72 up. And I'd like to acknowledge them with the ward councillor and the communicator naye, ward councillor Majek. Bonke ke bephethwe obekwisigqeba sika mayor uNelane onguye ke ongusodolophu walapha. We are very, very pleased that they have graced this occasion, because ke umama ebengumama wethu engumama we community engumama welizwe. So siyabulela for all that support. And I have to mention ke, O Judge Madlanga, the justices bakhona nabanye ngazubazi ke mhlambe I heard baba khona. We have to acknowledge and give Judge Madlanga yena in particular. We come a long way with him as a family, and we really appreciate that he has come to support us. Thank you very much. Let me start my vote of thanks this way. We are proud citizens of Mthatha and the Eastern Cape. We are proud products of our parents, Umthembu Max Mpahlwa, Nomama and Laura Khuluza Mpahlwa. We are proud sons of the soil who wish to carry on the legacy of our parents, but in particular, the legacy of Umama and Laura, the community builder. And this we want to do through the work of the foundation. We have to acknowledge the fact that the foundation, whilst it is centered and rooted in the family, has been driven by the children of the family, not us, nabazukulwane. And you saw the members of the board, how young they are. Umongezi ongunyana wami umzukulwana kamamlora has been the driving and the spearhead of pushing this foundation and got it registered, obviously consulting with us and the family, supported by obviously supported by other younger members of the family. Of course, Uko Dabso Abo Umandla, who has been in the background steering and coordinating us. Any information if you go to any Afiki, but all the same things were happening. And then you saw the young board members like Uayanda, Khazia, Okhazia, Gekwabanga Baziyo, Umamu Khazia, and our father were so close. Sasimbizu Tatobao, Kubanga Mthembu. So ke ikwa mzukulwana wasebathenjini lo, nobe ngumachangi sanje. So we are very pleased that she has been part of this and actively involved in it. Obviously, Uwasanda ke Ukangule has claimed himself as our youngest brother, but ke we've accepted without any doubt. And then I'm not going to call that name. Umandlakazi Junior Mpahlwa. I have to acknowledge and recognize her because for those who do not know, when my father was 3, his parents passed. Sivela eDutywa thina eMbewuleni, isinqese sethu silapha, and we still go there. So when uDedi was 3, his parents passed. His elder brother, uBongo, was already in Cape Town. So uTata Mdala uBongo took the 3-4-year-old Efika kwi youth age wamsa Cape Town. My dad grew up in Cape Town at District 6, apho ehlala khona. So uMamthembu ke lo uMandlakazi Junior ngumzukulwana kaTata Mdala uBongo, who is the one who looked after uMthembu Mkhulu wamfundisa at Cape Town. So we have to pay homage to oMpahlwa abasekuguleni, where she was born. And now she is part of the foundation. So that legacy, we are pleased that we are able to share it with the young members of the family, and they are driving it. And we are very pleased about that. So in so saying, we really congratulate the board of the foundation, which, as we have heard, is led by Ubradi Advocate Ntsabeza, who is one of the first people who received me next to my family when I was released from Robben Island. We met up at Fort Gale, Quark. And it was one of those experiences when I was coming out of prison being 27. I went to jail at 22 and spent those 5 years and came back to be met by Oprah D, who were very active at the time. So what I'm trying to say is that this legacy and these roots and these relationships we have as a family are very, very deep. Actually, ndithi elinye lamahlakani lakhe ikwa ngumzukulwane wabaThembu uMatthew ndimbona sehamba nekumkani andazi uba Mthembu ungene kanjani endlini yekumkani but ke iyacaca into yoba ilegacy that was left is kind of spreading in many different ways so we also welcome you and we should acknowledge you. In that spirit, I have to acknowledge abazukulwana basekhaya who were part of the welcoming team here. Nobulunga, Luluto, Ntombi Nqube, Ibhatyi ePink, I forgot her name, but umzukulwana also uSipho, yeah, uNasipho. And then uMbasa, abakaMandlakazi, noYanga. We really appreciate the fact that they decided to get involved and be part of the preparations of this event. I have to acknowledge those acknowledge uMamncane noBaba Dombo, uMamncane Juni. She made it a point. She is the last remaining sister of his siblings, kaMama. There were 8 all in all. Omalume Chris, nomalume Ubumba, couldn't make it, Basa Soweto. So we are also acknowledging our family from the Msemang family, Nongobo, which is my maternal side. And we are very, very honored that uMamncane uJuni, noBaba Dombo, noNyana wabo uLanganani, he is somewhere here. Basuka lewa Venda and decided to make the trip. We really, really appreciate that. Thank you very much. We have to thank WSU for hosting this inaugural lecture and for having kept everybody here until this time. I first have to apologize for this. It's our first time. I think we'll be able to tighten the program in the follow-up lectures. We've got school children who are here with us for all this evening. So, but I really, really want to say to WSU, we really, really wish to send our best and greatest thank yous for honoring us the way you have. You honored Umama with an honorary doctorate. You honored myself with an honorary doctorate, so I'm the alumni of this university myself. I want to tell those who do not know, that choir that we had here, when I was in Germany, we hosted that choir, No Professor Luswas, in Germany. They were invited to a festival of classical music in a town called I've forgotten it, but it is it is a festival of classical music that was founded by one of the German composers, Wagner, and that choir came to perform there among other international choirs. They actually closed the room when they mopped the floor there. And I had the pleasure, Prof. Lusos, President of Berlin, to actually invite them to come to Berlin and to perform. We organized a concert for them in one of the concert halls. And the admission fees for that concert, because we said Abantu are not going to come and listen for free to this kind of music. All the income from that concert went straight to the choir at the time. So I'm very pleased that WSU, you are carrying on that tradition of that choir, and I am blown away with the quality of the music and the training that these young students are getting. So thank you very much for that. We have to thank the Mthatha community. Without this community, Nathi as a family, we would not be where we are. I said we are proud citizens of this town. And we wish Sotolop, Mayor, MECs, all the leaders, General, you included, we really wish that this place, wherever it is going, it should retain its dignity. It should retain its quality. It should keep on producing the kinds of people it has produced among all these people who are sitting here. It's a town we don't quite recognize, I must be honest, but we are calling on the leaders of the people, the leaders of the province, the leaders of the city, of the municipality. We're calling on everybody to say that Mthatha cannot be allowed to be just another town. We are pleading for that, and we hope that through the work of the foundation, we can start elevating the work that the generation your mama have done, but also doing it in the context of Mthatha. So this is our plea, and we hope that in our lifetime, we'll see a turnaround of Mthatha. I've mentioned Professor Luswazi because to us, she has been part of the Mthatha community, though Gesatibana Emazweni, but I really have to acknowledge her as well. I'd like to thank you, St. John's. Hi, Lentak. Because we are proud alumni of that school, Sifundepa, and we are proud to have a principal, like the Principal Maka, who has actually kept Netimiak, Ihlelapo, who has kept the standard. I was once invited to come and speak at a matric ball as a former student. And in that year, I spoke, and because of obviously the talk I gave, we got 92% pass. So as a standard, it looks like it's being kept, and I really wish, it's a pity the principal just went out. I really wish to congratulate the school for the role that it's playing, and we really want to see new leaders, program director, coming out of that generation. In mentioning St. John's, we cannot mention the Diocese of St. John's, the church, which has also been supporting the family throughout. And we know that in the Tetilano Provost, it's Holy Week, they've got evening services, and they've not been able to make it, but I'm pretty sure Akwana Mahamende Akoyo. So we have to thank the church for that. I have to mention specifically, and the community as Mthatha, and now Shia Osis Maureen and her group. Osis Maureen, I think, is an older generation, your Nomkolis. Onomkolis, I figure, said, call Maureen. I know about the beauty pageant, which I think Utumato has expressed it in a manner I never thought of before, of actually having the idea of beauty with purpose and not just walking ramps, but actually building the capacity and the character. Umama ke also had a modeling school called Kolisa Modeling School. Sonke as youth of Balapentata, Nomzala Abo Komoto, we were all involved in some way or other in having to model Mama's clothes in the modeling school when she's having her shows. So she would hire professional models from Joburg, Bazo's teacher how to walk and all these things, and then we would kind of be part of the enterprise that Umama was leading. But being at school, going to university, not seeing that as a career per se. So I think that that kind of combination which our guest speaker expressed today or conveyed to us, social entrepreneurship, I think is just a fitting definition of what Mama stood for. So Sis Maureen and your group and Umwebsukona, Baninzi, oh, Jambona, Usana Afro, no. We are really, really proud to have that generation actually still continuing the relationship and connection with the family. We're very, very grateful for that. I think that it is very, very important that we, in concluding the families, there are members of the family that may not be here, but I am asked to convey their greetings and also their support for the work that we are doing, and especially in terms of having launched this foundation today here. It has been mentioned that nothing can happen without support, funding, and all this. So we have to acknowledge the sponsors that have been mentioned, the RH management group, there is the Eastern Cape, province, and others who are in the and we would like to, I noted when I was mentioning the SAT, that every seek to emulate her character, and we shall seek to represent what she stood for, both as a family, but also in particular through the work of the foundation. The theme ethi Imvuselelo, Rebirth of Active Citizenry, has nothing more to do than the fact that the relationships that our parents established, especially when I was growing up, as much as they were driven by our fight and struggle for democracy and a better society. But they were based and rooted in ensuring that we contribute towards a better society and a better community. In those days, the issue of political allegiance was not a deal breaker in terms of building communities, but it was saying, what is the value that each person brings in order for us to create a better society? I really hope that as we build and work towards whatever future we dream of, we should never forget that our communities, this is where we are, and this is where we want progress. This is where we want people to work together. And I think that the work of the foundation, at least even the themes that they have chosen, will help us to strengthen democracy by making sure that Umama was closer to communities like anybody I know. And I think if our work is not close to our communities, it will be difficult to actually create that future that we are looking for. I have to thank my family now. Ifamilia too is spread all over. I live in Cape Town, and I couldn't come with my family, unfortunately, due to various reasons. Basikhulele eNcebedlana, and we go back to eNcebedlana with pride. Noba indlela zimbi siyakhala, kodwa ke noko zilungise. And we really hope that those roots that we have will remain. Ditshilo ba sisedutywa, sisembewuleni apho sisuka khona, ndithethile ngeSoweto family. But our family, the Mphahla family, cannot be anything without the support that we received today, that we've received over the years, and that we hope to build on, because we know that that family could be where it was able to achieve through working with the community and everyone. I have to acknowledge Uskulu, our ambassador in Kigali, who has made the trip back. Umandisi, my younger brother, was directly after me. And we appreciate the support that he gives us in all what we do. And we know that through him, that legacy maybe lives in a different way. And we appreciate the role that he's playing in being part of representing us at the national level, as he was, but also now internationally. So we wish to thank you specifically for being that supportive role that you've always been. I have to mention those who are in the board. Mandla, thank you very much. Mongezi, for all your efforts. And Ndicela acknowledge someone who I think is quite important to us, Mam Chawe, who has honored us also today. Sabulela Mam Chawe, for taking the time to be with us. I have to thank our program director and say, program director, I think everybody here, it looks like you know everyone who's here anyway. I think that the role you've played really demonstrates that you actually knew the person that we are about. And I want to say to the audience, this is not the last one. We are going to need more of these to happen for it to take root and for this work to continue. There is a very, very important person that I actually, now looking around, thought I have to acknowledge, was one of Mama's closest friends, Aunt Maki, also took the trip from Joburg, I think, and Uhamba with Ubaba. I would like you to stand up also, because these are all people that Umama has related with throughout, and they have always been with us whenever we have events. So, ladies and gentlemen, Ndicela ukubulela as the last now, even though I started with her, our guest speaker. I find it difficult to say because abantu batheta ngomama Gloria, you know. But I'd like to thank you once again for gracing us and for actually presenting to us the kind of thought-provoking presentation of ideas that I haven't had in a long time. We really have to express our thanks, and we shall do so. Yeah, okay. But before that, I just want to say that with your acknowledgement goes the acknowledgement Gagaura, who also has played that supportive role to us. We've been, you know, together in places for many, many years. And I have to congratulate you and Wipold with Uwendi. Uwendi kenayo wagatsha zapha eMthatha and the Eastern Cape. But we're really, really proud of what you have achieved. And besides the theories of social entrepreneurship, the case study you've presented to us about what you are doing Kucendane, a Willow Vale, Emnqom, Empasha. It is unbelievable. Congratulations, guys. It is something that is starting to sow the seed. It might not be an Aunt Laura center. It probably will be a Gloria Wipold center, but carrying on the work that Aunt Laura started. So we thank you very much, and we really wish you all the best in your initiatives, in your programs, in your entrepreneurship, which to me looks like it is doing exactly the things that the program director mentioned. This is the Aunt Laura of the 21st century. Thank you very much. So I will. I've just been whispered to that I need to call upon the stage our guest speaker, Gloria. I have to call Professor Cliche, and I have to call the program director to the stage, please. I think Professor Cliche left. Usisi Yonela from WSU maybe can come and represent the Professor Cliche on stage, please.
Gift of the gifts.
So, this has not been kind of choreographed quite, but I've been asked, in fact, let me stand here, to say that as a token of appreciation from the foundation, there is those tokens that have been prepared, and we'd like to hand them over to our guest speaker. Just been corrected. These are from the foundation and WSU. Thank you. And then the next one to WSU itself. I don't know why it's giving itself presents. From us to them. Oh, I see. Okay. I said it's not choreographed, so I'm not quite sure. So please, to Professor Tlisha, a token of appreciation from the foundation. And then to our amazing program director, who it seems knows everybody who is here. It made it easy for him to manage the event. So thank you very much, Prof. Figeni, son of this university. So ladies and gentlemen, as far as I know, there is a cocktail. I'm pretty sure, now I'm hungry, basically. But I believe that there is an invitation which is open to everyone for a cocktail, and we can interact and network. There's no separation. Everybody will be in the same room, right? Thank you so much. Sabulela.
Kuthiwa ke sawuhamba ngolu hlobo xa silandela ikumkani to that cocktail. Abantwana ababesikolo kuba indlu isenokubancinane bazawuhlala apha. Enye into xa kubizwe igama elinecocktail ungabona sekukhona needrinkanyana ezithile ezingadibananga nesilabhasi. So kuloo ndawo bazawubalapha enzela uba siqiniseke uba kungena istoni nesprite nazo zonke iigruvi ezikhona. Nabanga kwazanga ukwenyukela bafike phayana, but they will be served here as well. Siyabulela. Si ulapha nomatshaya, ulapha nomama omdledle, bonke endingababizanga zawumani baqhwetha phaa kwi-cocktail. Thank you.
Thank you.